Hello guys, this is Thompson from 5 Best Ones. Are you looking for the best product on the market? If yes, then you're in the right place. In this video, I will share every bit of information with you so that you can pick the best product according to your need. We have made a list by investing a healthy amount of time and effort. The link in the description demonstrates the product list with a pretty reasonable value. So let's get started. If you didn't subscribe to our channel yet, then subscribe now and hit the bell icon for our latest videos.
Number 1. ASUS ProArt Display 27. The ASUS ProArt Display PA278QV is a very good budget-friendly monitor that's intended for creative professionals. Its superb ergonomics, high peak brightness, and wide viewing angles make it a good fit for nearly any type of workspace. It comes with good color accuracy out of the box, and it has an excellent HDR color gamut. However, it can't display a wide color gamut and doesn't support HDR. It has impressive gaming performance despite its professional-looking design, as it has a fast response time, adaptive sync support, and a 75 Hz refresh rate that makes fast motion look just a bit more fluid. Unfortunately, it has a low contrast ratio and mediocre black uniformity, which is expected of most IPS panels. On the bright side, it provides a generous number of USB ports and even has a pair of built-in speakers. The ASUS ProArt Display PA278QV is a very good monitor for content creators. Its high pixel density results in sharp images and text, and there's plenty of screen space to have multiple windows opened at the same time. It has superb ergonomics, wide viewing angles, and it gets bright enough for use in any lighting conditions. Unfortunately, its contrast ratio and black uniformity are both mediocre, so blacks look more grayish. It has near full coverage of the sRGB color space. However, its Adobe RGB coverage is only decent. The ASUS ProArt PA278QV design is simple and a bit boxy, very similar to Dell's ultra-sharp monitors, such as the Dell UltraSharp U2720Q. If you like this product, please check out the Amazon link in the description below. Number 2. LG 32UN88A32-inch Monitor. The LG 32UN880 has incredible color accuracy and an approachable price tag, making it an easy recommendation for creatives and gamers alike. But with just 350 nits of brightness, the HDR10 compatibility is a bit of a waste. That's right, the default stand for the LG 32UN880 is the type of ergonomic stand that clamps to your desk, not only saving a ton of space, but allowing for freedom of movement of the monitor that is really second to none. You can move this monitor up and down, rotate it 90 degrees to have a vertical display, rotate the actual stand to change where on your desk it appears, and tilt it in any direction. This is the type of monitor stand that you typically have to shell out extra cash for and have to install yourself. But this model just included right out of the box. It's a nice touch and easily makes this monitor worth the cash. Not that the rest of the package lags behind or anything. This is a 32-inch 4K monitor with a beautiful IPS display. It covers 95% of the DCI-P3 color gamut, which when combined with the 350 nits of brightness makes for an extremely comfortable experience when editing photos. Over the course of a couple of weeks and editing dozens of photos for reviews and features, we're still amazed by just how accurate and bright colors appear on this monitor. If you like this product, please check out the Amazon link in the description below. Number 3. BenQ 32 4K HDR Monitor. The BenQ EW3270U is a good 4K monitor with decent picture quality. It has a VA panel with a high native contrast ratio and decent black uniformity, allowing it to produce deep, uniform blacks. It has a low input lag and fast response time to deliver clear images with minimal motion blur. However, the refresh rate is limited to 60 Hz. Gamers will surely appreciate its FreeSync support and G-Sync compatibility, and although it supports HDR, this monitor can't get bright enough for a satisfying HDR experience. Also, its ergonomics are quite bad and its viewing angles are just okay, so it may be worth investing in a VESA mount if you often need to share work or content. Overall, it's a monitor that performs well for most uses, and its simple design should fit anywhere. The BenQ EW3270U is a good monitor for most uses. It's more suitable for dimmer environments as it can't get very bright, but it can display deep uniform blacks thanks to its VA panel. Its large screen size and 4K resolution are great for productivity and immersive gaming experiences. It can handle reflections well, but unfortunately, its ergonomics are quite bad, making it difficult to adjust to your optimal viewing position. It has a low input lag and its response time is good, resulting in very little motion blur. The BenQ EW3270U is a simple, professional-looking monitor that fits well in any office. If you like this product, please check out the Amazon link in the description below. Number 4. ASUS ROG Strix 17.3. The G713 series consists of at least 16 different configurations of various AMD CPU, GeForce GPU, battery sizes, and even thicknesses. There are good options to be found in there, but ours is perhaps not the best. The ROG Strix G713 series succeeds last year's G712 series by bumping off Intel for AMD and upgrading most SKU to GeForce Ampere graphics. Configurable options are extensive, with no less than 16 individual SKU, all detailed here on ASUS official product page. Options are subsequently massive, ranging from the Zen 2 Ryzen 7 4800H to the Zen 3 Ryzen 9 5900HX CPU and 65W GeForce GTX 1650 graphics up to the 130W GeForce RTX 3070. Display options also range wildly from the base 144HC FHD panel to 165HC QHD or 300HC FHD with fuller colors. Even battery capacities, thicknesses, and AC adapters are different depending on the graphics. Our test unit today is a mid-range SKU equipped with the Ryzen 7 5800H CPU, 95W RTX 3050 Ti GPU, and 144HC FHD display. Competitors in this space include other entry-level to mid-range 17.3-inch gaming laptops like the MSI Katana GF76, Acer Nitro 5, Dell G-Series, or Lenovo Legion 5. It can be difficult to tell apart all the different ROG Strix models since they share the same visual design. If you like this product, please check out the Amazon link in the description below. Number 5. Lenovo ThinkVision M14T14. The Lenovo ThinkVision M14 is a decent portable monitor. It's designed to be used as a secondary monitor when connected to a laptop, so it's limited in the number of inputs and features. There are only two USB-C inputs, so you need a laptop that supports DisplayPort Alt mode to use it. It has a smaller 14-inch screen, which is fine as a secondary screen, and with a 1080p resolution, it still has a high pixel density that makes images look sharp. The IPS panel has fairly wide viewing angles, but that means it has a low contrast ratio, so it's not a good choice for use in dark rooms. Being a portable monitor, it doesn't offer much in terms of ergonomics, but you can tilt it, and there's a small height adjustment stand so that you can make the screen even with your laptop. The Lenovo ThinkVision M14 is decent for office use. It's designed to be a secondary monitor on the go, so it's limited on inputs, and you need a USB-C connection for it to work. Even though it has a smaller 14-inch screen and 1080p resolution, it delivers clear text due to its high pixel density. It has okay brightness and decent reflection handling, but it's best to avoid using it in bright rooms. The Lenovo ThinkVision M14 is a basic-looking portable monitor. Please comment on which product you like the most. Let us know your opinion on the topic for our next video. We are done for today. See you again next week. Thank you.